I wanna take a ride on your disco stick. Let's have some fun. This beat is sick. I wanna take a ride on your disco stick. Let's have some fun. This beat is sick. I wanna take a ride on your disco stick. Let's have some fun. This beat is sick. I wanna take a ride on your disco stick. Let's have some fun. This beat is sick. I wanna take a ride on your disco
stick. I wanna kiss you. But if I do, then I might miss you, babe. It's complicated and stupid. Got my ass squeezed by sexy Cupid. Guess he wants to play.
Hello, my name is Karin, and this is...
I'm Peter Potter.
Hi, Peter. We're here at a very exciting event at the 2011 NPC Southern States Championship. So, Peter, tell me more about this contest today.
Okay, this is one of the largest amateur organizations and promotions in the United States. The NPC, which is our umbrella organization, and we're considered one of the large, whether you go to the West Coast or the East Coast. And we have 18 different states represented, as well as we're privileged to have a lot of people from South America and from the islands, Bahamas, Trinidad, all the different islands.
Well, that is wonderful. So for how many years has this been going on?
Okay, this is the 31st year.
Okay.
We've added recently the bikini, and this year we added men's physique, which is the first year we've done it. And we have about 260 competitors. The bikini, the fitness, the figure, and the men's physique we did last night. Tonight is bodybuilding. And we have bodybuilders all the way from teenagers that are 14 and 15,
wow,
all the way up to grandmasters who are over 70 years.
No way.
Yep. and they're very impressive. 70-year-old bodybuilders. Yeah,
I can
very
imagine. Different. So from what states do you have competitors here?
Well, of course, we have a very heavy concentration of Florida.
Yeah.
We also have from New England. We have people from Massachusetts. We have people from the Midwest. We also have people from Mid-Atlantic, Pennsylvania, Delaware. We also come down the South, Georgia, Mississippi, Alabama, Louisiana. We even have them some far as Washington State.
I have to admit that I am just so impressed with the women in this contest. I found Debbie, who is very, very gorgeous. She has this amazing body. And Debbie, tell us under which category you're competing.
I'm a lightweight bodybuilder, and I'm all natural. I don't do steroids, so I'm very proud of myself. And I have a lot of medical issues, and I just want to give a message out that women that have fibromyalgia or osteoporosis or rheumatoid arthritis, that they're able to get out there, and maybe not the level that I'm at, but I've done this for a year and a half, and 9 times out of 10, I get first place in my division, and I'm very proud of that as a natural, lightweight bodybuilder.
Only a year and a half? You got this body on a year and a half?
A year and a half. It's hard work. There's a lot of crying, a lot of pain, but here I am.
All right, this again is your women's lightweight class. Second place goes to Tammy Ulander. First place, Deborah Leyva. That's what they had written, okay. Deborah Leyva, excuse me. Let's stay in between them, raise your hand in victory. Stay right there. Let's raise your hand in victory. Good deal.
Hi, this is Theresa Pacheco for GNO here at the Southern State Championship Bodybuilding. And right next to me, I have Katie. Katie actually competed yesterday. Katie, how are you today?
I'm very good. How are you?
Good. So tell me exactly what happened last night.
Well, it was a great show. It was a lot of people in my class, about 11 people, and I came in sixth. I was in the top five for the first call out, but towards the end of the evening, they changed their mind. So.
That's wonderful. Now, how do you do to get this wonderful body? How much training does it take?
About an hour a day, 6 days a week, and my husband kicks my ass, or my butt every day. Sorry.
Your husband's also training.
Yes.
He also is in national, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we're both doing nationals at the end of the year this year in November, I believe.
Oh, wonderful. And what's your husband's name?
James Davis.
Ladies and gentlemen, it doesn't get any better than African-American men. How are you, Jimmy?
I'm good. How you doing?
I'm doing great. A little nervous here next to this amazing body. Jimmy, what categories are you competing today?
Doing the over 40 masters and the open heavyweight class.
Do you mind me asking how old are you?
No, I'm 47.
That's hard to believe. I see that you have a trophy here. So what? Tell us, what did you win?
I got third place in men's over 40 masters. And now I'm finna, you know, go and get ready for the heavyweight class by after intermission.
Okay. And where are you from?
From Orlando, Florida.
Orlando? So I see that you decided to work out instead to go into the parks?
Oh, yeah.
And how many hours a day, or what do you do to get this body?
Just work out five times a week. After I get off from work, you know, so been doing it about 20 years. So, you know, it's kind of like a hobby that I just have to do, you know what I mean?
Okay.
So I like it.
You don't think about it all the time. It's just a regular part of your routine.
Part of the day, you know what I mean?
And what does your diet consist of?
Right now it's rotating carbs. You know, I have two low days, one high day, and about an hour of cardio a day. You know, two sessions, split it up in two halves. So it's a full day. Plus, I got to go to work and do this too, so it's all good.
Can I ask you one question that I haven't asked anybody else?
Sure.
Can I touch those abs?
Yeah.
It feels good. Thank you.
Hot air. So hot in here. So hot air. Oh. You want a little bit of.
How are you again? And I have Alex Ramirez. And Alex actually trained Katie and got her in the best condition possible. How are you, Alex?
Well, very good. And for me, I have athletes like here. It's an honor to have athletes like Wendy. You know, it's I'm very proud because it's not only about me. It's about the team. If she don't do what I say her to do, we never can have the gold. Or we can realize what our dream is in this kind of sport. So it's very hard to get to that point. It's very hard to have the mind to get that point. And always you need to have somebody to do or to tell you how to do the things to get to that goal and at the end. You know? So it's very important to you realize and try to do the best you can. And at the same time, try to
have the discipline.
You know, discipline and heart. That's very important because you have the body, but you need to fix the body to can get to that moment, because it's only few minutes that you're going to be in the stage. But it's a long time, it's a long determination, it's a long of months and weeks. Okay, you're doing a nutrition, a special workout, okay, to get only to that few minutes is your goal. And after that goal is maintenance, and we try to keep that all the time.
So basically with women you've trained, how long realistically takes to get them into where you got Wendy here?
Well, normally it depends on the woman. So woman for me is better than man, and when we talk about discipline. Okay, yes. I have admiration for the women, because women they are more tolerant and they are more focused in so many points to get to that body that they want. Can be for fashion, can be for sport, can be for health, life, whatever. Always they want to do something to be in a very great shape.
Can't say enough about Peter. I guess I'm one of his youngest that he helped birth at the NPC National years ago. Well, back in 1982, I had a lot of hair flowing back then. So, but anyway, he's done a tremendous job in promoting the sport of bodybuilding here in Florida and around the world. When you think about bodybuilding, you always got to think about Florida as being number one. You got Florida and California. Yeah, that's correct. Give yourself some hands. I've had the opportunity to meet a lot of the contestants and hang out with them backstage a bit, and I must say they've done a tremendous job. They're in fantastic shape, a lot of hard work, and I know they're hungry and ready to get out and enjoy themselves. But I also like to say that the sport of bodybuilding has been good to me. I've always instilled impressed upon the athletes to live out their passion, enjoy what they do, never make excuses for who they are. I think bodybuilders are the best athletes in the world. We're not on and off seasons, we're always on. So, yeah, give them a hand. And the sport of bodybuilding has been good to me. I've traveled to more than 20 different countries around the world, and I've been able to make a great living at doing this. I was appointed by the President of the United States, had shows on ESPN, TBN, authored several books. I just released and introduced what is called the International Association of Fitness Science, which is the first personal trainer certification ever created by an Olympian. And I don't say I do that just as Lee Haney alone, but I take with me the knowledge that's been handed down from Arnold Schwarzenegger, Robbie Robinson, Larry Scott, Chris Dickerson, Frank Zane, Tamir Benoit, Tom Glass. Name an Olympian. I read everything that these guys put out and made available in the way of knowledge and information. And that is what this certification is all about. And I'm just thankful and I thank God that I can continue to live my passion and reinvent myself and take it to the next stages. And I'm also glad there's a lot of fat people in the world and people out of shape that I can promote it to, right? If it wasn't for McDonald's and Burger King, we wouldn't be in business. So anyway, those of you who love the sport of bodybuilding, love health and fitness, continue to do and live out that passion that God has given you. Thank you so much. God bless you, and I'll get a chance to meet you out here in the booth. Take care. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, it doesn't get any better than African-American men. Can I touch those abs? It feels good. Thank you.